with CNN's Bryn Gingras live at Elmhurst Hospital in Queens. A horrific 24-hour period there, Bryn, with 13 deaths. What's the latest?
Yeah, John, I mean, that's the grim reality of what we are seeing here on the ground, and it's not going away. The demand is still there. It's not slowing down. As you can see behind me, this line, John, it started forming even earlier this morning, and it's even longer at this hour. People waiting in the cold to get care. The hospital tells us every day they are working to increase the capacity of this hospital by flooding it with nurses and doctors and equipment just to keep up with this demand.
13 people have died at this hospital in Queens, while outside, it's swamped with New Yorkers waiting in long lines to get tested for the coronavirus. The numbers in the city are still rapidly growing, but the nation's top infectious disease expert says studying what's happening here could give clues to help reduce infection rates in other parts of the country.
It's accelerating. There are other parts of the country which we need to get a better feel for what is going on. And the way we do that is by increasing testing and identifying people who are infected, isolating them, getting out of circulation, and then do contact tracing.
New York Governor Andrew Cuomo reports there's early signs showing stay-at-home measures are working.
Social distancing, no restaurants, no non-essential workers. Yes, they are burdensome. By the way, they are effective, and the evidence suggests at this point that they have slowed the hospitalization.
Nationwide, some medical staff are fearful of working in hospitals overloaded with coronavirus patients, and the shortage of personal protective equipment makes their already difficult jobs even more dangerous.
We are terrified. Everybody is terrified. We feel an obligation to take care of our patients. Everybody does, but we don't want to become sick.
Watch medical personnel in New Jersey dressed in full protective gear move dozens of residents from this nursing home after several tested positive. And the Washington Post reports in Chicago, doctors have privately discussed a do not resuscitate policy for infected individuals, regardless of the wishes of the patient or their family members. With cases growing in Louisiana, the governor worries hospitals in New Orleans could reach capacity by the first week of April.
This depends upon whether the curve gets flattened or whether the trajectory stays where it is.
President Trump's still optimistic most of the country will be back to work soon.
It could be we'll do sections of our country. There's big sections of our country that are very, you know, little affected by what's taken place. Then there are other sections that are very heavily affected. By Easter, we'll have a recommendation.
But Dr. Anthony Fauci says it's basically impossible to make that projection.
You don't make the timeline. The virus makes the timeline. It doesn't matter what you say, 1 week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks. You've got to go with what the situation on the ground is.
Yeah, the hospital's so overwhelmed here that patients are having to actually be moved to other hospitals because there's just simply not enough room. Now, we know half of the cases in the country are here in New York. Listen, we've learned 40,000 nurses and doctors have volunteered, some retirees, to come back and help the hospital staff. Obviously, John, that is just heroic, as we know, because doctors and nurses are among the people that are getting sick right now.
Bryn, I have to say, you've been doing amazing work there. We see the ambulances behind you coming and going. We see the lines behind you growing, and it's only 6:06 a.m., and we've read the reports of the situation inside that hospital as apocalyptic. So thank you very much. Stand by and please.